Hey there, church family. I hope you're doing well whenever you're watching this video. Today, our Gospel Project story is a story you know. It's the story of Jesus and his resurrection and teaching around the life of his friend Lazarus. And so Lazarus is the brother of Mary and Martha, who we've talked about in a couple of other stories, and we'll definitely be talking about them in future Gospel Project lessons as well. But the story basically is Lazarus gets sick and is kind of clear to the people in his life that he's dying. Word gets sent to Jesus, and Jesus is like, okay, like, we're hearing Lazarus is sick. Jesus literally says, this sickness is not going to lead to death. And so they basically wait where they are for 3 or 4 days. And then they decide to get up, and Jesus is like, hey, we're going to go. We're going to wake up our friend Lazarus. And the disciples are like, hey, well, if he's just asleep, like, we're just going to go wake him up. Like, he's fine. And then Jesus is like, no, like, he's dead. Like, Lazarus has died. And then just this story has a bunch of really weird elements to it that are just kind of hard for our brains to understand based on how we think about death and how we think about life and those kinds of things. But Jesus is like, I'm glad I wasn't there. Like, I'm glad for your sake that I was not there so that the thing I'm about to do will make sense to you and will be an instructive moment for you. Because Jesus knows what he's going to do is he's going to go and he's going to bring Lazarus back to life. But he's going to walk through this process with both his disciples and with Mary and Martha. And so he gets to their town and has two different encounters with the sisters, who both are of the opinion that if Jesus had been there, that he could have saved Lazarus, healed Lazarus. But they both kind of have different mentalities of, like, one of them kind of thinks now it's too late, and the other one's like, hey, like, even now I still believe you could do this. And then Jesus asked to be taken to the tomb, and he asked for the tomb to be opened, and everybody's kind of like, hey, he's been dead days now, like, there's going to be a stink, and he's like, hey, like, just do what I ask. And then you get, like, the shortest verse in the Bible, which says, you know, Jesus wept, and then Jesus calls forth and tells Lazarus to get up and get out of the grave. And so Lazarus walks out in his grave clothes and is alive where he once had been dead. And so there's a lot that we could unpack in this story. I think for this week, the things I would encourage you to focus on as you're talking about the story with your families is, one, is just this is maybe like the ultimate example of Jesus' power is that, you know, we've seen Jesus heal and we've seen him do miracles with food and like all these things. But this is Jesus bringing back someone from the dead. Like, Jesus is regenerating a human being, bringing them back to life. So point that out to your kids, like, hey, Jesus has, when we talk about Jesus having power over everything, we mean even death. Like, even death must submit to the commands of Jesus. Like, another really interesting thing is the parallels this has between with what Jesus is actually going to have happen to him in weeks' time with his own death and his own resurrection, being, you know, in a tomb the same 3 days and, you know, coming out alive again. Lazarus is a really good picture of the perfect resurrection that Jesus was going to demonstrate, because when Jesus brings Lazarus back to life, Lazarus died again. Like, that Lazarus will die again in this scriptural timeline. But when Jesus is resurrected later on in the story, Jesus isn't going to die again. And Jesus is alive today bodily in heaven as the King of all kings. I think another good thing to point out with your family as well is the idea that, look at how Jesus grieves. Like, we use that verse of Jesus wept. Oh, it's a really easy verse to memorize and those kinds of things. But this was his friend. This was his friend who died. And he's sitting in the grief with that man's siblings, his two other friends. Jesus has a deep grief for people who are hurting, and this is one of those moments where you really get to see that come about. I think it's also not too far of a stretch to talk about that this is a symbolic of Jesus' grief over the spiritual death that everyone is afflicted by because of sin. That Jesus knows that, like, death is coming for all humans physically, and for a lot of human beings who haven't put their trust in him, spiritual death is also what they're sitting in, and is also what's afflicting them. And so I don't think it's a stretch here to say that Jesus is also grieving the spiritual death that so many are experiencing. And then when he brings Lazarus back to life, it's again the symbolic moment of Jesus has not only the power over, you know, physical death, but he also has the power over spiritual death. But that's the story of Lazarus. Again, John chapter 11 is a long chapter. I encourage you to read it with your family this week, with your kids. The big idea was just Jesus has power over death. Jesus raised Lazarus from the dead. With your students, we're going to go with more of that angle of Jesus grieves over the death of his friend, and that this whole story kind of foreshadows his own death and resurrection that is to come a little bit later on in the gospel accounts of his life. I hope you're doing well. I hope this has been a good week for you and your family. I hope you got to enjoy the cooler weather and the rain at the beginning of the week. And until I get to see you again, either in person or in the next video, God bless.